What are these structures?
They are an order of Zoa, characterized by extreme largeness. We will call them MegaZoa.
So, they are alive?
Yes! These MegaZoa feature extraordinary physical durability for organic matter. We will call this exact species of MegaZoa Calamitosia. Attempt to scan their interior for more data.
Thank you.
spanning this Calamitosea. These Megazoa are characterized by microscopic cilia used for a respiration process that is extremely efficient. The Calamitosea appear to be evolved for life on a planetary surface of conditions not hostile for ongoing livelihood.
More hospitable than the surface of Mars today, I assume.
Yes. These Calamitosea also contain extremely long root-like organs, which appear to have prehensile properties.
And here is Octo's camera module. These are the structures seen in his transmission.
I am acquiring data from the module. Attention! Octo intentionally left this module within transmission distance of the prior module.
But we did not pick up this transmission when we were near the first camera.
This camera module is no longer at full power.
Octo's cameras have lain here for several months. We hope for a chain of communication. It is now broken.
Thank you. course I knew nothing like a silly little enormous destructive cave-in would be enough to kill you.
What is the situation?
The outpost is just gone. Here's the deal. You need to make your way down to base camp. We can both survive here until the GSA arrives in a few months. They're scrambling a rescue operation right now. The surface conditions are too hostile for that suit you're wearing, so travel through the cave to get here. Hopefully, it actually connects. I think it does.
So I must climb deeper into Left Cavern. It's no longer an option to proceed slowly.
Yeah, no. You probably have 24 hours of life support left, and the cave is more extensive than we assumed. The GSA says you can continue pursuing safe research opportunities, though.
Did you see the area I just passed through?
Yeah, I'm uploading your data now. Crazy structures, wow. MegaZoa. Nice job researching them. Covered in cilia? What are they, some kind of breathing apparatus? Huh. I'm not into art's names, though. We need something colloquial. Can't we nickname them, like, periscopes or something? Hey, and you know that flat plane you were standing on? I think it's the former surface of the planet, buried billions of years ago by lava from the Tharsis uplift. I'm dying to know what's underneath. Something much older than the lava tubes, that's for sure. Guess you'll find out.
Yes, if I don't want to die myself. Already it grows cold in this suit. Wish me luck, buddy.
Good luck, Leon. There's an entrance back into the cave below where you're standing. It will be my pleasure to hand you a cup of rehydrated cider upon your arrival. Now, get back into that cave.
About the life form we just passed through.
It is a genus of cerebrate. We will call it Byzania. This genus thrives at boundaries between the cave interior and the planet surface. It effectively seals these boundaries, protecting the cave from hostile surface conditions. Attention! This is a type of fertile terrain that is especially beneficial for Zoa growth.
Interesting. How does fertile terrain come to be enriched?
Your inquiry has no currently valid answer. I will create a corresponding objective in the research log.
Is this another MegaZoa, Art?
Yes! We will call them Alveoporidae. This MegaZoa consists of bundled packs of sensitive fibers.
What are the fibers sensitive to?
There are several types of fibers. They are activated by carbon dioxide, or nitrogen, or argon, or oxygen, or...
Are these the compounds released by Zoa?
The full list has measurable overlap with compounds released by mature Zoa and Phyta. This alveopyrus is currently at its highest activation level.
We should nickname these harvesters then. How do the harvesters' fibers behave when activated?
The activated fibers are consuming compounds from the air and converting them into electrochemical energy. This alveopyrus produces a larger quantity of electrochemical energy than it requires for sustenance.
What happens to this surplus electrochemical energy?
It is transferred down the root-like organs to an unknown destination, deeper in the cave.